थ्योरी एंड प्रैक्टिस ऑफ सेल्वी गर्चर लेक्चर नंबर 10. इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अबाउट द सेल्वी गर्चर सिस्टम. इन द सेल्वी गर्चर सिस्टम विल स्टडी अबाउट द सिस्टम ऑफ कंसंट्रेटेड रीजनरेशन, सिस्टम ऑफ डिफ्यूज रीजनरेशन, एक्सेसरी सिस्टम एंड कॉपी सिस्टम. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज सेल्वी गर्चर सिस्टम. सो द साइंस ऑफ प्रोड्यूसिंग and tending a forest from regeneration to harvesting. So here I say from regeneration to harvesting. So this science of producing or tending a forest from regeneration to harvesting is called silviculture system. Let's understand again by three things. All the silviculture system including three basic component. Number one is called harvest, number two is regeneration, and number three is tending. We are having three things: harvest, regeneration, and tending. These three basic components is a part of a silviculture system. These components are designed to mimic natural processes and conditions, fostering the healthy, vigorous stand of a tree. So silviculture systems help us to develop a stand, to renew a stand. So in this process we have three things. Let's go back again: harvesting, regeneration, and tending. Now first is harvesting. The mature crop has to be harvested and create condition necessary to favor a regeneration and establishment of a new stand. So harvesting is very important. Only when we harvest, by harvesting we'll get revenue, and the trees which has been mature enough has to be harvested, then only we can have a new crops to come up there. So harvesting, when we do it, we'll have a new crops which is a space is been created for the new regeneration to come up there. So to be regenerated and establishment, harvesting is very important. Number two is regeneration. After harvesting, our prime duty or prime objective is regeneration. Regeneration depend on silviculture of tree species. Now different tree species have a different requirement of regeneration. As we earlier lecture we have gone through cereal regeneration, cereal species, or climax vegetation, how to regenerate the climax species. So a regeneration method is a process by which a stand establishes or renewed. So the regeneration depend on silviculture requirement of the species. What is the requirement of the species? How that could be regenerate? Some regenerate in open, in the light. Some regenerate in moderate shade. Some are shade bearers. So that is the knowledge of a forester, how to regenerate the crop. Then tending. The third feature is tending. Tending is very important, and it is for the health of the species, for the health of the forest. Tending includes a variety of intermediate treatments that begin after regeneration. After regeneration happens, from the seedling to the mature crops, we have to do tending. Tending is done to improve the stand composition, structure, growth, quality, and health to produce the specific benefit as you desire. Maybe we go for pruning, we go for a thinning, we go for clamber cutting. So to improve the forest condition, to improve the tree species, that is called tending. Now overall silviculture system, by these three things: harvesting, regeneration, and tending. So let's see. Harvesting is the first part where we go, we have to harvest the mature trees. But harvesting also depend which type of tree species or what are is silviculture of tree species, is it clear felling, is it shelter wood system, is it selection forest, how to harvest it. So first we do harvesting, and harvesting, what it does, it helps us to regenerate or establish the regeneration. So this is the part called regeneration. So here after harvesting, the objective is regeneration. So this regeneration has to develop into seedling, then sapling, and a tree again to be harvested when it matures. So regeneration, we have to take care from seedling to pole to mature tree. For that process, from seedling to mature, we do tending. Tending is a process for the vigorousness, for the good health, where we go for thinning in the early stage, where we go for weeding, where we go for pruning, and many other operation, intermediate operations we go to improve the forest crop. Ultimate, it becomes a very well developed tree species or very well developed forest, so we can go for harvesting again. We have to go for regeneration. So we can see the advanced growth here already coming before harvesting, so I'll be teaching that one in the coming lectures. So before that, we have to classify the silviculture system. So it has been classified in way of even age and uneven age in the copies also. Even age system has been called classified into system of concentrated regeneration, and uneven age will go for the diffuse regeneration. So let's classify this one. Most commonly, classification is based primarily on the mode of regeneration, and this is further classified according to the pattern of felling carried out in a crop. According to the mode of regeneration, silviculture system are classified into two main categories. One is called high forest and one is called coppice forest. Now what do you mean by high forest? High forest are those silviculture system in which regeneration is normally of seedling origin, based on sexual reproduction germinated through seeds. Those forests coming up from seed to seedling origination, we call it high forest, where the rotation is generally long. And what is coppice system? Coppice system are those silviculture system in which the crop originate mainly from coppice and the rotation is small. So we'll be studying both high forest and the coppice system. Now let's go for the classification of high forest system. So high forest system is classified, and I told you, system of concentrated regeneration. We have here even age. We have even age, maybe age gradation. We call it here age gradation. Or here we can see age class. Okay, both are even age here. And then next one is system of diffuse regeneration. We see there is no age class. Tree species is from 1 day to 100 to 200 years. Then we have accessory systems. There are three systems in high forest. One system of concentrated regeneration, system of diffuse regeneration, system of accessory system. In system of concentrated regeneration, we have two. One is called clear felling system, other one is called shelter wood system. Under clear felling system, we have the clear felling system, number one. Number two is the clear strip system. Number three is the alternate strip system. Under the system of concentrated regeneration, B is shelter wood system. Under the shelter wood system, we have the eight system. Number one is shelter wood uniform system, shelter wood group system, shelter wood strip system, Wagner's, Blender's, Sam's log, Eberhard's wedge system, strip and group system, irregular shelter wood system, and Indian irregular shelter wood system. And under the high forest system, now there is a system of diffuse regeneration, where we don't have age class nor we have age gradations here. So the forest crop is uneven age here, and we have two systems under that. Is one is called selection system, other one is called group selection system, and the third one is SSE system, which doesn't come under system of concentrated regeneration nor under system of refuge generation. Here SSE system, we have three systems. One is called the two-storied high forest system, then we have high forest with a reserve system and improvement fellings. So we'll be studying this in the entire course. The first one is called the clear felling system. The clear felling system, the crop is absolutely even age here. The character of the crop is even age here. Now let's see what is clear felling system. The clear felling system is defined as a silviculture system in which the equal or equiproductive areas of mature crop are successively clear felled in one operation to be regenerated, most frequently artificial, sometimes naturally also. Now what does it mean? It means that clear felling system is a silviculture system in which equal or equiproductive. Now equiproductive means, when I say equiproductive, it means that we make the coppes, or we coppe means annual felling area. If annual felling area, we fell it here in one operation, this area, one area, this area, entire area, we have made one annual felling area or vehicle coppice, or number, this is another coppice, this is the third coppice. We, when we fell this annual coppice in that, in 1 year, it should be equiproductive. Equiproductive means the harvest what we get should be equal. All coppices should have equal. It means to say that whether we have to make the equiproductive areas. So for example, this area is 1 hectare. In 1 hectare, we are getting 100 quintal, for example, wood. For example, this 100 quintal should be equiproductive areas. It means the site is not so fertile enough. It may be very poor also. So we may increase to 2 hectare. So we have made it 2 hectare, but the yield is again 100 quintal. It means that equiproductive area, coppice should not be a fixed area like 1 hectare coppice we are putting. We somewhere 1 hectare, somewhere 2 hectare, somewhere 1.5, somewhere 3 hectare, but the product, but the harvest should be equal, called equiproductive. Now let's read it back. The clear felling system is defined as a silviculture system in which equal or equiproductive areas of mature crop are felled in one operation to be regenerated either naturally, either artificially, but more frequently we do artificial instead of natural. This is in clear felling system. But in shelterwood system and selection system, we go for more natural regeneration. But here our more concentration is artificial. So we say more frequently artificially we go for regeneration. Okay. Now according to definition, the crop of the coppice should be felled and removed in one operation. It should be felled in one operation, that says the clear felling system. But we have some variations are there, that is very important to understand. Sometimes somebody will ask you, these are some variation, how it is clear felling? Variation is what? What variation we are keeping here? So the variation is retention of some mature trees. We have to retain some mature trees. We are retaining, we are not doing clear felling all, some trees we are putting there, maybe for frost protection, but that is for an insurance against failure. By chance the entire regeneration we are putting artificially or naturally, it has been burned by forest fire and all has been gone away, so we don't have any seed now left. So these trees will help us to give seeds, that is the insurance against failure, and sometimes also help against frost. These trees, this promise, sometimes this promising group of saplings and poles which is not mature, so we don't sacrifice them, sometimes we don't cut them, let it be there for 5-6 years so that become mature and give us more wood. So sometimes there are two things: either we retain some of the mature trees for what? For protection against frost or insurance against the failure of regeneration. Second, we keep some saplings and poles which is immature, so that in coming 2-3 years we can cut down when it is mature. This is some variation in clear felling system. We should know about these variations also. Now, method of opening or obtaining regeneration. How we obtain regeneration in clear felling system? In clear felling system, regeneration is obtained mostly artificial. Sometimes naturally also we do. We'll discuss both. Okay. But artificial regeneration is preferred to natural regeneration. We prefer more artificial regeneration than by natural. Why? Because it is the surest and quickest method of improving crop composition. Number one. Number two, this artificial regeneration also helps in introduction of fast growing and high yielding exotics we can put, and by our own wish, which is the best species, like we are putting eucalyptus there. Then it completes regeneration very fast. Fast growing we are putting, regeneration is completed fast, it will establish more sooner. So we can not go for more weeding in that area. Then area can be opened for grazing soon, because whenever we do this clear felling system and when we do regenerating that area, nearby we have lot of villages or some vicinities, some habitations are there, they have lot of cattle which will graze. So if we keep on closing that area for a long time, they may have enmity and they may not help us, help the forest departments. So if we say them that we are closing it for 3-4 years, they have a good will, after that we can open them for the grazing. But if we close it for long time, it is very difficult with the villagers or with the people staying vicinity to stay in very congenial way. So that is, we can open for grazing and allow them grazing by taking some fees in some area when the villages are nearby the forest. So we can open up for grazing sooner also. So method of artificial rejuvenation. Now let's understand the method of artificial rejuvenation. There are two methods. One is called departmental plantation. I'm talking of artificial rejuvenation, natural rejuvenation, I'll talk later. So method of artificial rejuvenation is departmental plantation and tongia plantation. Tongia is a Burmese word. Hill cultivation, tong hill ya cultivation. Tongia is a Burmese word. It was introduced by Brandeis. Now we'll discuss about the method of artificial rejuvenation in clear felling system. As I told you, when we have departmental plantation, another one is the tongia. Tongia is further divided or further classified into three subheads. One is called departmental tongia, lease tongia, and village tongia. We should not be confused with departmental plantation and departmental tongia. Departmental plantation is different, tongia is different. In tongia, we have three subheads. One is called departmental tongia, lease tongia, and village tongia. Next one is called method of natural rejuvenation. Method of rejuvenation is through seeds and through advanced growth. As in clear felling system, rejuvenation, more we do frequently artificial rejuvenation, very less we do natural rejuvenation. We'll discuss that part also. First is natural rejuvenation from seed and advanced growth. Now, natural rejuvenation from seed and advanced growth has three subheads. One is seed stored in the area, seed received from the outside, natural regeneration from advanced growth. These are three subheads. Now we'll discuss these three subheads. But this method of natural regeneration we only do when we are very certain about the natural regeneration in that area, then only we do, otherwise we do artificial regeneration. Now let's discuss the first part, that is called method of artificial rejuvenation. Under methods of artificial rejuvenation in clear felling system, we have two. One is called the departmental plantation, other one is called the tongia. We have three subheads already discussed, that is departmental tongia, lease tongia, or village tongia. But here we'll discuss about the departmental plantation. Now departmental plantation, what we do after clear felling system? First of all, we divide the area into annual copies. We have to make in annual copies. We'll auction this forest. While auction this forest, we'll serially number it, and we'll number for those we have to return and those we have to sell it. So the contractor has to do felling, and into the contractor we make them sure that they will fell the tree at least 60 to 75 centimeter below the ground, and also do clear burning after the harvesting of that one. They have to remove all the slash and everything from that area. After that, we do plowing of that area. We plow that area by a tractor if it is a plain area. Then we have to take care if it is a slope area, what type of pit we have to make. We have to make the pit, and we have to put the soil on the lower side of the slope. And we have to, after making the tractor plowing, the preparation of that one, we'll make a treatment map. In the treatment map, we'll see what is the where is the pit to be done, what is the spacing of the pit, what is the size of the pit. After that one, we'll demark the area for the specific tree species in the treatment map, suitability of the tree species. And treatment map will make according to the species, which species has to be planted there. Then in the coming monsoon or in the coming planting season, we will plant that particular species as per the treatment map. After planting, we will go for the weeding, and then we will go for the fencing. So this way we will do departmental plantation after clear felling. So we have some example of the departmental plantation. Number one is called Allapalli technique for teak. Here we will go for more stump planting, but the area also depend on artificial regeneration. But if only advanced growth is 750 per hectare in mark for natural regeneration. So again the coupe is demarcated and treatment map is prepared. We'll have workable and non-workable areas both. So the unworkable areas
Areas will include 20 meter strips along nalas and very steep slopes. Then only dead dank disease will be felt there. This is unworkable area. So other area, what we'll do? We'll be working for 2 years, where timber extraction will be done, sale will be done, and then we'll go for plantation of stump planting. That is how much spacing? 2 meter into 2 meter. We'll stake there one. And then also you have advanced growth there. So 2 meter by 2 meter will do stump plantings after rain. And then 3 weedings will do in the first year, 2 weedings will do in the second year, and 1 weeding will do in the third year. Then your teak will grow good enough. After that, in the 5th year will go for thinning. Then the second thinning will go in the 10th year, and the third thinning will go in the 18th year. This is Alla Pally technique for teak, which is done by stump planting. Next is casuarina plantation. So it is done in coastal sands of all states having sea coast, where we go for naked root plants here also. Not only naked root plants, we go for ball of earth and container plants also, where water is very scarce. So what we do there, we do tractor plowing, and planting is done in June, July. So pits will make 30 centimeter deep there. So we can go for a spacing of 1.8 meter to 3.6 meters, so 1.8 meter into 1.1 meter, or we can go up to 3.6 meter into 3.6 meter for casuarina plantations. So planting will be done in June to July, and watering is very important in the first year. And or if it is not possible there, we can make a 2 temporary wells per hectare, and then from there watering we have to do. So that is very important in the beginning, because there is a coastal area, sand doesn't have a water holding capacity. So we can go for naked root plant, ball of earth, and container plants. And the third one is Cryptomeria and Cupressus planting, which is done in West Bengal Himalayas. That is 1000 mean sea level to 2400 mean sea level altitude, and rainfall is 2500 millimeter to 5000 millimeter. So here actually the objective was growing fast growing exotic trees to replace the indigenous slow growing one. So naked root plants were preferred, 30 centimeter pit deep, 1.8 meter to 1.8 meter or 2.5 to 2.5 spacing was preferred for this Cryptomeria and Cuprosus plantation of West Bengal Himalayas. Then Tongia. Now we have come for Tongia. Already I discussed about the Tongia. We are having 3 categories for Tongia. One is called departmental Tongia, another one is called lease Tongia, and the third one is called village Tongia. Yeah. Departmental Tongia is very costly actually, because we have to keep the weed down. For that one we are doing departmental Tongia. In that one, department, forest department is involved raising the agriculture crop along the forestry tree crops. So in departmental Tongias, mostly it is generally not very successful, because foresters are not very expert in raising the agriculture crop. So their concentration is more on agriculture crop to make it more better, and they ignore the forest crop. So it is generally failed. So departmental Tongia is very less successful. Lease Tongia means we lease that area to some person who gives more money. And in lease Tongia, what we do, we let them grow the agriculture crops and to take care the forestry tree crops for 2 to 3 years. Later, when your trees are big enough, then we can increase or decrease the lease Tongia also. Village Tongia means we'll give the villagers to grow the agriculture crop along the forestry crops. Forestry crop will be taken care by the villagers for in due course of time when they grow agriculture crop. So in this way, weed can be also suppressed, and your tree species can also be taken care. So that is more better, like village Tongias can be done. So there are some examples we can go. One example is Sukna Karchiong division technique for Sal. This is a village or departmental Tongia, both Tongia. This has been done due to failure of natural regeneration of Sal due to dense growth there. So this was given to the village Tongia. So what happened, the Sal was sown under miscellaneous species like Chucrasia tabularis or Schemia wallacei or Terminalia species. So 8 by 8 meter Michaelia champaca was planted, and Bombay sea bass planted 16 meter into by 16 meter, and in between salve sown in lines in 2 meter apart. After 9 lines of sal, again 3 lines of miscellaneous species were raised. So this was the technique of Sukna technique for sal, where the villagers were allowed to do intercultivation in the first 2 years. They did maize and sesamum, etc. From the third year, when the crown closure was there, so what happened? They grew this, what is it, turmeric. So this is the example of village Tongia of Sukna technique for sal. Next is Nilambar technique for teak. Here area is leased. This is a leased Tongia. So area is leased or auctioned by only 5 to 10 hectare or maybe increased. So after clear felling and extraction of the timber there, and the area is planted by teak stumps, and that spacing is 2 by 2 meter in April in May. So sowing of paddy is allowed now after the stump planting is completed now. If demand exists, then fresh lease can be given in the next year, second year. So the lease holder has to weed the forest plants and give protection. This is the duty for the lease. So it is more benefit. We get money also, and the weed is also been suppressed. So here is a paddy and here is a teak which has been grown here. This is Nilambar technique for teak as leased Tongia, example of leased Tongia. Example of village Tongia again, South Gorakhpur technique for sal. Here what happens, after clear felling, the land is distributed among Tongia cultivators to dig stumps and make charcoal also, that which stumps are been remaining. So after 1 year, free cultivation they are allowed, and they dig trench also, and so the seed of forest species is done. Now what we do, when we do clear felling, we retain the trees like Maduka Indica, Mahua or Mango or other fruit trees, we don't fell that one. Now in that area, the cultivators cultivate their agriculture crop for 4 years. So when the sal becomes 1 meter high, up to that they cultivate. So this way, South Gorakhpur technique for sal is a village Tongia. Now after artificial regeneration, we have discussed about the departmental plantation and Tongias as an artificial regeneration, which we do more frequently. But sometimes we also do method of natural regeneration. Only when natural regeneration is absolutely certain that natural regeneration will come, then only we do. We have some examples of natural regeneration, that is from seed and advanced growth. There are 3 examples. One is seed stored in the area, next is seed received from outside, and third one is natural regeneration from advanced growth. Let's discuss the first part called seed stored in the area. When I talk of seed stored in the area, then we have to take care, means that this is the forest where seed is already there. This is called seed stored in the area, means seeds are available in the forest floor. After harvesting, these seeds will germinate. This is called seed stored in the area. It doesn't happen with all the species actually. It can happen only with a few condition, like teak is one example, because teak has prolonged viability of seed. It should have a prolonged viability of seed, then only it can germinate. Second is seed ripening coincide with felling. Suppose this seed has been ripened, as it fall down and the trees are already mature and we have to cut down the trees, seed has already fallen down, which is coinciding with the felling, then only it will come. That is seed stored in that area. There are 2 cases. One typical example is Pinus pinaster. There's an example in Landes in France. It happens there, where we harvest and we get lot of regeneration there. We don't need to go for artificial regeneration. So there are 2 examples here. One is a teak here in India, and acacia means we may be discussing here this one also. Next one is seed received from outside. Number 2 category is seed received from outside. Now you can see that the seed which is coming from outside, either through water, either through from birds. So this is one example in Sindh in Pakistan, where we have a seed coming from the Indus river from a flood, acacia or babool we call it, acacia species, which is coming from the Indus river, and it is coming through the flood, and with the flood the seeds is coming. After the flood recedes back, then this acacia, they germinate, and germination is not sufficient, we can go for broadcasting also there. Next example is in Chichwanti and Changamanga in Pakistan, again where the seed
is coming from outside through irrigation or through birds. That is a Morus indica seed. There's a rosy starling bird. Rosy starling bird perching in this Dalbergia sisu plant. They are perching here, and then their seeds is been dispersed by bird from here or by irrigation water, where Morus indica seeds is been coming here in Changamanga or Chichwanti place in Pakistan. This is one example of Pakistan in seed received from outside. In India, there is a seed received from outside is Avicennia's, is a mangrove species in a tidal Indonesian coming in the coastal areas in Andhra Pradesh. Due to this tidal, the seed is to come as tide go back. This Avicennia's, they germinate here. This is one example of seed received from outside in India. Then the third category is the natural regeneration from advanced growth. So when it is only surest, this is the surest method, because already advanced growth means only the seedlings which have already been germinated and are in a sapling or seedling stage. This is called advanced growth. So we have trees, and under that shade of the trees already the seed has been germinated and it is in the seedling or in the sapling stage, called advanced growth. This is very surest method. So what we do here, but here there is one thing, this germinations already been established here. We harvest the tree and we depend on the germination, or we depend on the regeneration from advanced growth. Means when we harvest, lot of damage happens to these seedlings, lot of damage happens to these seedlings, but nothing to matter, because after this damage happens, we cut back this damaged seedlings back. We cut back, as we cut back again, it will copies from here. We call it seedling copies. This term is seedling copies, not a copies forest. It doesn't become a copies forest, because copies forest is cutting down a tree. When we cut down a tree, and from the stool when it comes, when we cut down a tree, this from the stool, this is stool when we cut down. And from here, when the coppice comes out, it doesn't give a big timber, it gives a small timber. But when we have a coppice from the seedling, it becomes again like a high forest, a big timber it becomes. That's why there's a difference of a coppice and a seedling coppice. So seedling coppice ultimately becomes a high forest only. So it can happen in Shorya Robusta and Tectona Grandis very nicely. These are the example in our country. There's one example called North Betul Madhya Pradesh technique for teak, one example. Another example is Saranda in Bihar technique for sal. Then South Raipur in Madhya Pradesh technique for sal. These are the natural regeneration from advanced growth for Shorya Robusta and for teak, from that either from seedling copies, either from advanced regeneration. Is the same thing. Advanced regeneration, seedling copies, we should not be confused, because advanced regeneration, when it breaks up or get damaged, when we cut it back and again the regeneration or the copies from there it comes out, it is called the seedling copies. So this is the third and is the surest method. Then in this clear felling system, after harvesting and regeneration, tending is very, very important. The three things in silviculture system I told you is harvesting, regeneration and tending. Tending, what we do, other than the village tongia, three weedings are required in the first year for sowing, and only two or one is required in the planting. But the weedings are carried out in second and third also in case of sowing. So weeding is very important in the first year, in the second year, even in the third year. And then when the seedling sapling, it becomes a pole and a tree, later we can go for the fifth year onwards, that is we can call cleaning and thinning. Thinning is removal of congested trees or which are close to each other, so that the competition is reduced, and then we get a clear bole and a big tree, get a space so they develop nicely. So that is what tending operations. Thank you very much in this lecture of a clear felling system. We'll go in the next lecture of the clear strip system and the alternate strip system. Keep watching. Thank you very much.